जय हिंद एवरीवन। आई अश्विनी शर्मा प्लीज टू वेलकम यू ऑल एट माय यूट्यूब चैनल अनुपम केमिस्ट्री क्लासेस। इन टुडेज लेक्चर आई एम गोइंग टू शेयर सम इनसाइट ऑफ फोटोफिस रीअरेंजमेंट, Barton reaction and rearrangement of acyclic alpha beta unsaturated ketones. This is my second lecture on this topic, organic photochemistry. In the previous lecture I have discussed about introduction of photochemistry, some terms and the types of photochemical reactions. So here we start our second lecture, that is photofrizz rearrangement. What is photofrizz rearrangement? This is a rearrangement reaction in which phenol ester in solution on photolysis give a mixture of ortho and para acyl phenols. So phenol ester get convert into acyl phenols during this rearrangement. Solvent case effect are not operative in the gas phase, so many other products are formed in the presence of a catalyst. So we will going to discuss what is this solvent case effect in our next slide. Now catalyst is required during the reaction, like required during Frizz rearrangement. I hope you have studied about Frizz rearrangement. In Frizz rearrangement, aluminium trichloride is used as catalyst to bring the same change. Okay, what is the mechanism of this rearrangement? In the first step, the phenol ester dissociate. In the first step, it absorbs energy, photo energy, and get converted into the excited state. And in this excited state, it dissociate to form two free radicals. This phenoxy free radical and this is acyl free radical. So you can see these two free radicals are in a cage like structure, means they cannot move away from each other. The solvent kept both these free radicals with each other. So this situation where two free radicals formed during a particular step must be kept in the proximity of each other is known as solvent case. So due to this solvent case, this acyl free radical will attack only at this particular phenoxy free radical. So it will attack either at ortho position or at the para position. If ortho position are already occupied, then it will attack at para position, but preference will be given to the ortho position. So first it will attack at ortho position, and here after the shifting of this hydrogen atom, it acquires the aromatic characters and we get ortho acyl phenol. In the same way, the next product, that is para acyl phenol, is also formed. So in the gas phase, this solvent cage effect is not possible. These two free radicals are free to move everywhere in the reaction container. So due to this free movement, these free radicals are free to combine with any other free radicals. Say this acyl free radical may combine with another acyl free radical, so we will get a different type of product. Similarly, this phenoxy free radical may also combine with another phenoxy free radical, so we will get third type of product. So in case of gas phase, we will get different type of products. Even phenol is also formed during this reaction. One hydrogen may get shipped from a solvent or another free radical, and it will form the phenol molecule. Okay, it is an intramolecular free radical process. Phenol is also formed as a side product during the reaction. Allyl, phenyl, ether also show rearrangement under thermal condition. One such problem is as follows. So basically it is three sigma tropic rearrangement. So allyl, phenyl, ether get converted into orthoallyl phenols. Some more examples of photophysic rearrangement are also there. Phenyl hydrogen sulfate get converted into ortho hydroxy benzene sulfonic acid or para hydroxy benzene sulfonic acid. That also follow the same mechanism or the same pathway. Next is N phenyl acetamide get converted into ortho amino acetophenone and para amino acetophenone by following the same reaction mechanism. So this is the photofreeze rearrangement. Okay, next is Barton reaction or photolysis of nitrite. This reaction is also known as Barton nitrite ester reaction. So what is Barton reaction? Barton reaction is the reaction photolytic conversion of organic nitrites into nitro alcohol take place. Okay, this reaction involves photolysis of an alkyl nitrite to form a delta nitroso alcohol. The irradiation of alkyl nitrite generate the oxy radical which abstract hydrogen from delta CH bond. The alkyl radical thus form combined with nitric oxide free radical liberated in the photolysis to give a nitroso compound which tautomerize to corresponding oxime. So this is the reaction of this is the mechanism of this particular reaction. So first of all, an alcohol is converted into an alkyl nitrite by treating it with nitrosyl chloride in pyridine solvent. So after the formation of this alkyl nitrite, the further process will start. Actually, during this reaction, this carbon at 1, 2, 3 and 4th position gets converted into either OH or get converted into NOH or simply in a carbonyl functional group. So what is the reaction? In the first step, the photolysis of this O and bond take place and one nitric oxide free radical get eliminated and we will get oxy free radical. After formation of this oxy free radical, one hydrogen at delta position is abstracted and alkyl free radical is formed. Now the nitric oxide free radical that was dissociated during the first step of the reaction recombine with the alkyl free radical to form delta nitroso alcohol. Right, this delta nitroso alcohol tautomerize to form the oxime. So this nitroso alcohol may be isolated as diamer or may rearrange into oxime. The nitroso and oxymo compound produced may further be transformed into the functional derivatives such as carbonyl compounds, cyano compounds and amino compounds, right? So this may be converted into this carbonyl compound or into cyano compounds or in amino compounds. So what overall change takes place during this reaction? You can compare this reactant with this product, okay, or this reactant with this product, this alkyl nitrite. You may see that here in this alkyl nitrite we have hydrogen at the delta position alpha, beta, gamma and delta position, and here in this case we have one NO group at the same position. This nitroso get converted into oxime. So overall what changes take place during Barton reaction? This hydrogen is substituted by this NOH group during this reaction. So if you are given the reactant, then you have to, and this particular reaction, if you have alkyl nitrite as reactant and you are asked to treat it in acidic condition, then what you have to do, you have to just put this NO at here on the place of this hydrogen and shift this hydrogen at this OH, right? Now this CH2 unit, okay, this is CH2 unit get converted into CO unit after the hydrolysis of oxygen. So you know that alkanes or the CH2 unit is less reactive as compared to the carbonyl group or the cyano group or the amino group. So this less reactive position, this less reactive delta position or this less reactive CH2 get converted into more reactive carbonyl or amino or cyano group during the course of this Barton reaction. Now one question may arise in your mind that why only delta hydrogen get abstracted during this reaction. So this answer, the answer of this question is hidden at here in this particular structure. You can see during the shifting of this hydrogen, one 6 member transition state is formed. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. This 6 member transition state is formed during the conversion of this oxygen free radical to alkyl free radical, right? And you know that 6 membered cyclic structures, whether it is transition state or it is a cyclocompound, they are more stable as compared to the 5 or 7 membered structures. So only after, by shifting this hydrogen, 6 membered transition state is formed. So the stability of this cyclic transition state is responsible for abstraction of this delta hydrogen, right? So this, after the completion of this reaction, you may have know that it is very simple reaction. What you have to do, you have to just put this NO on the place of this hydrogen and shift this hydrogen at this with this oxygen. So we will get this delta nitroso alcohol during this reaction. Okay, in some cases this reaction do not follow this path, it may perform disproportionation reaction. This disproportionation reaction occur in primary and secondary nitrites without delta hydrogen. So if nitrite do not have delta hydrogen, in that case disproportionation reaction take place and we will get two products. One is carbonyl, that is the oxidized product, and that second is the alcohol, it is the reduction product. Intramolecular abstraction of hydrogen atom by alkoxyl radical is always accompanied by disproportionation and radical decomposition. Okay, you can see this particular reactant do not have delta hydrogen. So disproportionation will take place in case of secondary and tertiary nitrites. This is tertiary nitrite nitroso alcohol rearranged, and in case of primary decomposition take place. So this decompose to form this particular nitroso compound and this carbonyl compound. So what are the applications of this Barton reaction? Application: this reaction is used to synthesize aldosterone as its 21 acetate from corticosterone acetate. You can see this is corticosterone acetate, and we convert this into aldosterone acetate by treating it with nitrosyl chloride in pyridine and then irradiating it, we get this particular product. So here at this position we will at this position the nitric oxide will get attached with this oxygen, and after hydrolysis we will get the aldosterone 21 acetate. So here are two problems that were asked in different competitive exams. So this is the reactant, it is alpha, beta, gamma and delta. So you have to put the NO at here at this position, it will get converted into get protonized to form the oxygen. This is the second problem. Here you have arranged this ONO group in the below the plane or away from the reader. So here we have more than one delta hydrogen. So it is alpha, beta, gamma and delta hydrogen. One delta hydrogen is at here, alpha, beta, gamma and delta. Second is at here, alpha, beta, gamma and delta. Third is here, alpha, beta, gamma and delta. Fourth is here. But what is the problem? Problem is that the shifting of hydrogen, you know that during the abstraction of hydrogen cyclic transition state is formed. So it is not possible to form a cyclic transition state between this carbon, because it is above the plane and this carbon or this ONO group is below the plane. So it is not possible or not feasible to form cyclic transition state with these four, these three delta hydrogen. So only one possibility is there, this delta hydrogen get abstract by this oxygen. So this NO will shift here, and after the acidic hydrolysis we will get the final product. Okay, so this is the Barton reaction. Last is rearrangement of acyclic alpha beta unsaturated ketones. Conversion of conjugated system to unconjugated system. So during rearrangement of acyclic alpha beta unsaturated ketones, one conjugated system get converted into unconjugated system. When alpha beta unsaturated ketones having a gamma hydrogen are irradiated, a double bond migration occurs. Right? The gamma hydrogen abstraction and its transfer to the oxygen atom occurs via six membered cyclic transition state. So here we have the alpha beta, this is carbonyl group, and the carbon here to this carbonyl group is alpha, it is beta. So it is alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compound, and it is gamma, this is gamma hydrogen. So this gamma hydrogen gets shifted from this gamma carbon to the oxygen, or one this six member cyclic transition state is formed. So this hydrogen from gamma position shift at here, and this double bond will shift between the beta gamma carbon, right? So this system is conjugated system and it is non-conjugated system. Here we have two single bonds, two sigma bonds between these two double bonds. So it is non-conjugated and less stable system is formed. So during this reaction, during the rearrangement of acyclic alpha beta unsaturated ketones, we get less stable non-conjugated system. Okay, now you can see one more interesting thing here, and I hope you know that the energy required to convert this conjugated system into non-conjugated system is less as compared to the reverse process. Means if we want to convert this non-conjugated system into this conjugated system, we require more energy. So it means this reaction is this irreversible reaction. So there is no equilibrium. The reason for this is that irradiation is carried out at a wavelength absorbed by the conjugated substrate, and since this is longer than that absorbed by the non-conjugated product, so this is our third reaction. So I hope you got the points what I was trying to explain. Thank you students, thank you very much for patience listening. You may share your comments and suggestions, that will always be welcomed at Unknown Chemistry classes. Thank you very much.